Welcome to Douglas County News Exchange. I'm your host, Lena Hardy. We begin our show this month by spotlighting the Independence Day Parade, hosted by the City of Douglasville. DCTV 23 was honored to participate in the parade with the 2020 Census team. Be sure to learn more about the upcoming census and how to get involved. Douglas County Parks and Recreation hosted a ribbon-cutting ceremony at Boundary Waters Park on July 10th. To celebrate the completion of the brand new concession stand, press box, and restrooms. Several of our local politicians and county personnel were in attendance. Here are their remarks.
Today is important. It's important because we're celebrating the completion of one of the first initial SPLOST projects Douglas County voters approved on November 8, 2016. The SPLOST began on 2017. This brand new facility also has restrooms and will be used primarily for the Douglas County Soccer Association, activities that come along with it, and Boundary Waters football programs, and the Athletic Association as well. Following the ribbon cutting ceremony, we invite you to take a tour provided by the Douglas County Parks and Recreations. It's also important to recognize our Park and Security Department officers who are here with us as well, please. It's individuals like these who help provide security and help notify us when the facility is open as well as closed. This facility is important because what we're also unveiling today is the press box that'll be located on top of the facility, which will allow us to communicate and share not only football games, but as well as broadcast when we can soccer games as well. It's a facility that is special for the public and just something that has come after 2 years of building. In addition to what I have to say, it's important to allow others who are critical in making this happen. I'd like to now introduce our County Administrator, Mr. Mark Teal.
Just like to thank everybody for coming. Just to let, if some of you don't know, most of this entire facility was part of the 2002 SPLOST. It only included fine grading these two fields. So we have since finished the football field, put the lights up on the soccer, and then this facility here. So the lights on the soccer and this facility is part of the 2016 SPLOST. And without your SPLOST pennies, none of this would be possible, and we appreciate it.
Thank you, thank you. I'd like to take this time to introduce the Vice Chair of the Parks and Recreation Committee, which helped oversight this, Ms. Commissioner Tarinia Carthen.
Thank you all for coming out today. It's a beautiful day to be doing a ribbon cutting and to dedicate back to what's the most important to us, which is the youth. Our youth are the heartbeat of Douglas County. So I believe the best use of our money is to invest it in our future, which are our students. And can we give them a hand? Because they're here today. They could have been anywhere, but they're here. Yeah. It's vitally important as part of the Board of Commissioners, we do projects like these. These are projects that really help with our quality of life here in Douglas County. So to be a part of the Parks and Recreation Department Committee and to work with Director Gary Dukes on this has been an absolute pleasure. So again, when you invest in Douglas County, when you take time to spend your dollars at Arbor Place or Taco Bell or any of the facilities around, you help to make these types of ventures possible. So give yourselves a hand and thank you for being a part of Douglas County. Now let's see what this beautiful facility has to offer and invite more people out so that we can cheer on our youth. When they do football camps, when they're doing soccer camps, we want them to have a beautiful facility that they can partake in, that they can invite their friends and parents out to see. And it's possible because of you. So again, thank you, Douglas County.
One thing to note, this facility itself and the structure of Boundary Waters is in District 2. Vice Chairman, next remarks from Vice Chairman of the Board of Commissioners, Mr. Kelly Robinson.
I'll be very quick. Very simply, while it is in District 2, it began in District 3. This is a regional park. This is a super park. This is what we call a mega park. And think about it, as our county administrator stated, it's almost taken 20 years to fulfill this. Everything on a SPLOS cannot get done. Our wish list of needs far exceed your tax dollars. And so it's important that we want you to know we're going to take our time, be deliberate, be strategic, and prioritize what we do. But we hope that this facility, this whole complex as it comes online, fulfills the needs of you, the taxpayers. That's important to know. It took time to do this. Think about it. We had a field, a soccer field, and a football field, but no restrooms. So how could we really use this facility without your kids, what, running all the way down there to the baseball field or that way? Right? And so we recognize that. So what I want to give credit to is Gary Dukes, with all his years of experience, who actually came up and worked with the architect to come up with this master design. So can we give him one more hand clap for nailing this building? Thank you. So again, that's all I want to say. I want to acknowledge this has been a big effort. It took us our time. It took a minute. But again, hopefully you'll be satisfied with this results. And again, we're not finished with this park. This is a 500-acre mega park. We've got one more thing we need to deliver, and we'll deliver it next year, which is that community center. So I'm going to end on that note, and we'll just see you this time next year. Thank you.
Connect Douglas is up and running on the streets of Douglas County. With everything you need to know about the new fixed route bus service, here's the Connect Douglas PSA.
In an effort to meet the growing transit and mobility needs of our county, the Douglas County Board of Commissioners has expanded transportation options for citizens with the Connect Douglas fixed route bus service. Whether you're up for dining, shopping, working, or enjoying the many amenities of Douglas County, Connect Douglas's fixed route bus service will help to connect you to the places you want to go. Fixed route means the bus will travel the same path and serve the same locations every day. There will be established stops along each route. However, the driver can pick you up anywhere along the route, provided there is a safe place to pull over and let you board. We will also offer flex route, which means by calling ahead, the bus can deviate from its route and pick you up at your location, provided you are within the perimeter of the area we have established for this service. For seniors and people with disabilities who cannot get to the established pickup points on the route, we will offer ADA paratransit. You must call ahead and make a reservation for this service. There is a simple certification process and additional charges may apply.
We are so excited about the new fixed route shuttle system that we're bringing to Douglas County. To begin with, we'll be operating Monday through Friday from 6 a.m. to 8 p.m. and Saturdays from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m.
One-way fares are $2.50. You can pay with exact cash as you board the bus or purchase a multi-trip pass at the Douglas County Transportation Center located at 8800 Doris Road in Douglasville. Discounted tickets of $1 are offered to senior adults age 60 and older, students, and individuals with disabilities. A photo ID discount card will be issued after completing a simple verification process at the Douglas County Transportation Center. Individuals will use the discount card when boarding the bus or paying for a multi-trip pass. The vehicles are called cutaways and are more like vans than buses. Each cutaway can carry a driver, 12 ambulatory passengers, and 2 wheelchairs. The vehicles have a wheelchair lift, a bicycle rack, audio announcement system, a fare box, security cameras, and digital destination signs. The Connect Douglas fixed route bus service will begin with 4 routes. Route 10 service area will include North Douglasville, the Boys and Girls Club, Arbor Place Mall, Walmart, Sam's, the Douglas County Health Center, and Douglasville Conference Center. Route 20 service area will include Douglas County Courthouse, Wellstar Hospital, West Georgia Technical College, Target Shopping Center, Georgia Highlands College, and the Douglasville Post Office. Route 30 will serve Thornton Road Walmart, Cobb West Business Park and Six Flags Industrial Park, Tributary Community and the Employment Hub, including the Amazon Fulfillment Center, West Rock, Medline, and Coloplast. Route 40 connects to Routes 10, 20, and 30 to provide service from Douglasville to the Lithia Springs area. This route will also provide a connection to Cobb Link Route 30, which will provide a connection to the HE Home Smarta Station. For more information about Connect Douglas Fixed Route Bus Service and the many ways the Douglas County Division of Transit Services serves the citizens of Douglas County, please visit us online at connectdouglas.com or contact us at 770-949-7600. 665.
As many of you know, the inside of the courthouse has been under construction for the past 6 months. But I'm happy to say that the security renovations are now complete. A press conference and ribbon-cutting ceremony was held to alert the public on upcoming changes happening at the courthouse. Take a look.
It's an honor and a privilege to be here this morning amongst members of the judicial staff and our Board of Commissioners and the Douglas County Sheriff's Office. Because without all of them operating as one, collaborating with so many moving parts, we would not have been able to successfully reach this day, the day of successfully completing the Douglas County Security Renovations Project, which began in February, physically in February, with construction. When the topic of security is brought up, oftentimes it's a result of a tragedy, but that is not the case here. That is not the case because proactive steps have been made, not reactive. And it's important to note that. We are gathered here this morning to announce the date. The front entrance will open to the general public and discuss significant changes as a result of the major courthouse security renovation project. Without further ado, Chairman of the Douglas County Board of Commissioners, Dr. Ramona Jackson Jones.
Good morning. Good morning. Beginning Tuesday, August 13th, at 8 a.m., we will be offering a new experience for the citizens of Douglas County when visiting the courthouse. On this day, we will reopen the front main entrance of the courthouse to the general public. This will be the only entrance and exit for the general public at this time since enhancing new security measures. The side entrances, commonly known as Truth and Liberty entrance, will now be closed and only used as emergency exits only. This renovation project is beautiful, immaculate, and the courthouse is now complete. This renovation project that began with the remodeling of offices for the Solicitor General and the Office of the Public Defender will allow for a better working environment for staff and the general public. This look brings new enhanced security measures with a brand new screening process to help with efficiency. There are now 4 lanes for the public and 2 lanes available for the employees to go through the turnstiles. The Douglas County Sheriff's Office oversees the security protection of the courthouse. With that said, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Sheriff Tim Pounds and the Court Services Administration team of Major Lindy West, who's here with us today, and Captain Russ Brown. Thank you so much. At this time, I will turn it over to my Director of Communications and Community Relations, Mr. Rick Martin.
This was a process that began in part in 2017 when the Board of Commissioners contracted with Comprehensive Program Services to provide the county with an updated security evaluation for the courthouse facility. Working with the Douglas County Sheriff's Office, its staff, the courts, county administrator, and others, a plan was developed to meet 3 objectives, 3 primary objectives. 1, close security gaps and enhance the sheriff's capabilities to deal with situations that threaten the safety and security of all persons at the courthouse. 2, increase the sheriff's ability to screen visitors more quickly and efficiently in the facility. And 3, increase the safety of court staff and elected officials entering the courthouse by expanding and enhancing the secure parking capability. A design was developed to meet these objectives in the most cost-efficient way possible and to minimize the need for additional personnel where possible. Working with a seasoned architect and a contractor with expertise in court security, a new screening area and additional court space was created. There are many challenges to this. Remodeling an existing facility that's been here for 20 years was no easy task.
The primary challenge was expanding the security screening area within the current footprint of the facility and matching the design of the original structure. The new challenges to the courthouse meet all of these criteria. At this time, if there are any questions from the press, please feel free to ask. Now it's time for any Q&A. That's what I like. It's really important to remember Tuesday, August 13th, 8 o'clock. Lives will change, but for the better. And that is really important for us to know that and recognize. Access to the courthouse will be through the front entrance only. The doors at both sides, Truth and Liberty, again, as the chairman said, will be closed for all entry or exit, unless emergency cases arise. At this time, I truly like to invite one of our interns, Justin Bell, to escort our judges and Board of Commissioners out the side exit, where we'll have the ribbon cutting ceremony. All those, I'd like to ask if you could be seated so they get in place, in position. At this time, we'll also allow the media to exit out the door as well. Judges, please feel free to exit at this time. And Board of Commissioners and the Sheriff's Office for the ribbon cutting ceremony, which will occur in the lobby.
The Cultural Arts Council recently partnered with the Douglas County School System to launch a new initiative called Be the Change. Its purpose is to not only enhance the community and to improve our way of life, but to also ignite imagination, encourage thought, and to prompt discourse. With more details on this project, here's the CAC's Executive Director, Emily Leitner.
So we recently launched our public art initiative, and we wanted it to become and use public art to transform the community as our dynamic center and a destination spot for visitors and for our community. So we started with different projects like our fire hydrant project, which is called Arts on Fire, and all the hydrants from the CAC to O'Neill Plaza are now painted. And we did this in partnership with the school system, WSA, and the fire department. We did one school as the pilot program. It's called Be the Change Project. And with this project, in partnership with the Douglas County School System, we were able to bring words of affirmation into the school, thanks to Principal Kelly at the elementary school. So these words of affirmation are so influential in a time where bullying is such an issue. We are able to hopefully make just a small difference with a word saying, be kind, or you are beautiful. I know everybody can use those words at all ages, and to know that you are enough. You are worthwhile. If I had to pick one saying, and I think that is something that all of us need to hear, and it applies to everybody, that you are enough, and you are amazing, and you are beautiful, and you are kind, and all of that encompasses in those words. That your potential and what you're doing can make an influence, and each one of us can make a difference, but together we can make change.
Let the countdown begin. September Saturday's festival at the Douglas County Courthouse will be here before we know it. On September 21st and September 28th, from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m., the courthouse grounds will become a party, and this is your invitation. It's one of the largest county festivals of the year, and we hope to see you there. That's our show for this month. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to check out all of our programming on DCTV 23. You can find us on Comcast Channel 23, AT&T U-verse Channel 99, and online at dctv23.com. We end our show with a monthly birthday celebration for seniors at the Woody Fight Senior Center. See you next time.
All right, welcome to the Woody Fight July birthday celebration. I'm so glad that you are here. We've got a number of people with birthdays this month, and some of them are kind of special. We'll get into that later. Normally, our chairperson, Dr. Ramona Jackson-Jones, is here, but she could not be here. She has had to be out of state for a funeral. So, but on her behalf and on the behalf of all the commissioners of Douglas County, they wanted me to wish you all a very happy, blessed birthday. So they are thinking about you today. All right, I'm going to be coming around, and we'll be talking to folks that have their birthday. Your name?
Nancy McPherson. Okay. Was born in Atlanta, right?
All right.
Homegrown.
Okay, and when's your birthday?
Today.
Today, okay. Special day today.
My name is Claudia Swift, and I was born in Forest City, Arkansas.
When's your birthday?
Oh, my birthday is July the 22nd.
22nd. So you still got a few days to go there. So, okay, right here.
Jerry Latham, born 7/8/46, and I am 73, will be.
All right. And where were you born?
Loudoun, Tennessee.
Loudoun, Tennessee. So we're in Tennessee now. Yeah. Okay.
Hello.
Dot Smith, and my birthday is July the 16th, born in Atlanta, Georgia. And I'm not telling my age.
All right. You don't have to. I said that, didn't it? That you did not have to tell your age. Very good. Okay. Another Atlanta, Georgia.
Laura Brown, born in Kansas City, Missouri, July 19th.
You going to tell your age?
Nope.
Okay.
Janice Wehunt, I was born in Washington, D.C., and my birthday is the 21st, 44.
Okay. Somehow I think that's the year, honey. All right, let's go over here. This is, let me tell you who this is. This is a special person to me. This is Reverend Robert Wiley.
Wow.
How about that? He was my pastor for many years, okay? And so this is his birthday month. How old are we, Bob?
76.
You will be 78. July the...
That's not the one I want to be.
Okay. Well, honey, you don't have to be at this age, okay? Okay, and where were you born?
She's answering pretty good.
Yeah, she is. Okay. Yeah, in Kentucky, right?
Yes.
Okie doke. Okay. He's a special man to me. Sir?
Jeremiah Ford. I was born in New York City on July 9th, 1944.
74. Okay, very good. This is another special person because I got her when she first moved here to the States, right? So tell them your name.
My name is Nirmala Jhaveri. I'm from India. I'm turning 82 now. That's okay.
Right. She is a special lady around here.
All right. I'm Charlene Gruber, and I was born in Glassport, Pennsylvania, which is near Pittsburgh, and my birthday is on Sunday, July the 7th, and I'll be 92.
All right. And I will note that her husband over here was the oldest male at our senior picnic this year. So, and he is 95, okay?
93.
Well, you know, I got to add a little there. Okay, here we go.
Okay, I am Lynn Barama. And I am 62. I was born here in Douglasville, and my birthday is July 22nd, same as yours. Yeah.
All right. Finally got a homegrown one here, so. All right, sir.
My name's Clinton Brooks, Jr. I was born in Troy, Alabama, July the 24th, 1948. I'm 70 years old. I'll be 71 this month.
Very good.
My name is Patricia. I was born in upstate New York, and I look good for 85.
Yes, you do, honey. Yes, you do. All right.
I'm Dolores Whitten. I was born in Forest City, Minnesota, and I'll be 90 the 18th.
Okay, 90 years old. Okay, just hang on, Betty. I got the floor right now, okay? This is another special lady. She has been at the Woody Fight Center a very long time. She was one of our volunteers for a very long time. She helped take care of the plants, among other things. And the birthday, that's right. So give us your information.
My name is Betty Keefe. I was born on July the 4th, 1924. I was born in London, England, and I was a war bride in World War II. We were married 64 years. And what else do I need?
How old are you, Betty?
I'm 95 years old.
She was 95 as of yesterday, so. How about that? Okay. Hey, honey.
Hi, sweetheart.
Okay. What's your name?
Mamie Reynolds.
Okay. And when's your birthday?
July the 6th.
The 6th, so tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
You gonna tell me your age?
Yes. I'll be 76 tomorrow.
Okay. And where were you born?
Shaw, Mississippi.
Okay, Mississippi. You're the first Mississippi we've had. All right, dear.
My name is Barbara Tillery. I was born July the 20th, 1943, and I'll be 76. And I was born in Woodbury, Georgia, 30 miles below Columbus, Georgia.
Okay, you're almost to Florida at that point. Yeah. Okay. All right.
I'm Susan Fugate. I was born in Detroit, Michigan. My birthday is July 29th, 1947.
Okay. Are you telling the age or not? No, I can figure it out, but that's okay.
Sheila Rice. I was born in Des Moines, Iowa on July 21. We have another one, right? 1943. So we're all war babies.
There you go. Okay.
I'm Karen Campbell, and I was born in Edison, New Jersey on July 16th. And I'm going to be 69.
Okay. And where were you born?
Edison, New Jersey.
Edison, New Jersey. Okay.
Scotty Jeffries, born at Gadsden, Alabama, July 15th, 1930, antique.
You going to tell us your age?
I'm going to be 89 next week.
All right. All right. So, I got you all right. All right, did I miss any birthday people? Okay. Well, honey, it's time to sing then. So, everybody tuned up and ready? Okay. Happy birthday
to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you.